Today, I want to look at a common task that we often have to do as photographers, and that's remove unwanted objects from our images. And I'm going to do this using Affinity Photo. Now, if you've read my book, Essential Affinity Photo, you'll probably recognize the example image on the screen. It's one I show how to clean up these problem areas. Now, I'll just zoom in. At 150%, you can see the first problem. And we've got a bird here, and I don't want it, so we'll remove it. And that's going to be really easy. The next example is these fingers that have crept into the side of the frame. And I want to remove that as well. And again, should be quite simple, but there are a few problems to watch out for with some of the tools. Next, we're going to tackle this stadium lighting and how to remove that. It's getting a little bit more complicated, but there's a few secrets that I want to share with you. And then the final adjustment that I want to do is remove this window. Now, the tools we can use in Affinity Photo are over in the panel on the left, and there's a selection of them. There's only ever one icon showing, but if you look at the bottom corner here, we actually have a little arrow. And if you click on that, it pops out with the rest of the tools. Now, the tools we're going to be looking at are the Healing Brush tool, the Patch tool, and the Inpainting tool. And all of these can be used to make repairs, but they don't all make a good job of every repair. You've got to understand which ones will work well and which ones won't, and then you plan your repair accordingly. And I'm going to show you how to do that with these progressively more difficult repair jobs. So let's start with the first one, which is this bird. Now, the easy way to do this is with the Healing Brush tool. And I'm sure a lot of you are already familiar with this. So I've got the Healing Brush tool selected at the moment. I just simply size my brush and click to remove the bird. Now, I don't actually want to do that at the moment. And the reason is it will apply the repair directly to my image or my pixel layer here. And I don't want that. What I want to do is repair this to a separate layer. That way, if I make a mess, I can just delete the layer or turn the layer off, and then the bird will come back. Let's start by adding a new layer. So if I go to layer and just click new layer, and then I can put in here bird repair. With the layer renamed, I can now apply my repair to it. So I've got the Healing Brush selected. The thing that I need to do is set a sample, but before I do that, I need to make a change to the settings of the brush. If you look up here into the toolbar, you'll see it's set at current layer. Now, there is another option, which is current layer and below, and I want to use that. Now, what this means is I can sample from all the layers in the image and apply that sample as a repair onto the current layer. Watch what happens. If I hold down the Alt key to make a sample, so we'll sample from the clear blue sky next to the bird, and that then will apply the repair. So you can see that it's made a really good job. Let's just undo that for the moment, and I'll just put it back to current layer. Now what happens is if I use the current layer, same sample, and click on it, it doesn't remove the bird. And that's because there's nothing on the current layer. If you turn off the background layer, it's completely empty. So what you need to do is always have this current layer and below, and that way you can apply the repair to a new layer. I'll just apply that repair again. There it is. And if I turn off the background layer now, you can see the repair. Now let's look at the fingers at the side of the frame. It looks like it should be a simple repair. So I can make a sample here from the side of the fingers. So I'm sampling from something that's very similar to the area I want to repair. I can then apply my repair. But look, it doesn't make a good job of it. And that's because I can't surround the area I want to repair with the entire brush. I'm just going to undo that. The tool that I want to use to repair this with isn't the Healing Brush tool. The best tool for this is actually the, if I can just get this up, the Inpainting tool. So all I have to do here is, again, make sure that I've got current layer and below selected, so I'm applying the repair onto my new layer. And now I can just paint over the thing that I want to repair. An Affinity Photo will analyze that area, find something very similar, and make a repair using it. So again, I can remove the other finger. Now, when I paint in this repair, what I'm trying to do is be quite precise. I don't want to make too large a repair because that then becomes easy to see. Let's take a look at something that's a little bit more complicated, which is this stadium lighting. I could increase the size of my brush quite considerably and paint over the stadium lighting, but it makes a mess. And that's because I'm trying to make too large a repair to an area that's quite complex. I'll just undo that. Now, the secret to making complex repairs like this is to plan your repair. Now, what we could do is deal with what I call edges first. Now, an edge is where the object that you want to repair crosses over with another object in the image. If you look at this example, you can see that the stadium lighting actually crosses over with the fence. So I'm just going to reduce my brush size down, and we could deal with that. That's going to be an area that we need to actually fix quite carefully. The other area where we've got one of these edges crossing is here, where the lighting crosses with the background hills. The Inpainting tool may or may not be the best tool for this job. Let's have a look how it deals with first this area. It's made a reasonable job of that. If you didn't know that the hill was flat there in the background, you wouldn't be able to tell that that had been repaired. I'll just undo it and let's try for an even smaller area of a repair. And there it's made a really good job of it. Now watch what happens if I try to repair this bit with the fence. Now I'm expecting it to make a bit of a mess of it. It has actually, it's done a fairly good job, but it's not perfect. So I'm just going to undo that. The other tool I could use to do this is the healing brush tool again. Now I'm just going to size that down, and this time I want to sample from an area here where we have a vertical post. So I've placed the repair there, and now it will actually copy that post over onto the repair area. And I've got a perfect repair, and it lines up with the other part of the fence here. So I've now isolated the rest of the post here against a clear background. The stadium lighting further up is also isolated against a background. So I can now switch back to the Inpainting tool, and I'll just paint up this column, and that makes a good repair. I'll paint over that column, and that's made a good repair. And now I'll just size my brush and paint over the stadium lighting there, and it's made a good repair there. By breaking down what looks like a complex repair into a number of areas and then using the right tool that suits that area, we've made an excellent repair. Let's just now move over to look at how we would get rid of the window and the column here. So I could use the Inpainting tool. Let's just see what happens. Okay, it's actually made a reasonably good job of that, so we could accept that. But I want to show you another tool, so let's have a look at undoing that. And this time I want to show you the Patch tool. Now, the Patch tool is very simple. All we need to do is again make sure that we've got this set to current layer and below, because we're making our repair to a new layer. I can now click and draw around the window where I want to make the selection. So I've now selected the area for the repair, and now I can sample another area to use in that repair. So let's have a look at the column there, and that looks pretty good. And now I can just line up my repair. When I'm happy, I click. Now what that does is it creates this bounding box around the area that I'm using for the repair. And I can actually tilt that to line up the column or the repair more closely. I've resized it, tilted it slightly, and now it's looking like it's made a reasonable job of the repair. And I can now accept that. And we have our repair. Now, this line here isn't quite going up to the column as before. So what you can do then is just use the healing brush tool to clean that edge and just copy it over to that side. Now, I'm just going to undo that. This time, rather than actually setting a repair, what you can do is click this option here. Selection is source. And again, I'm going to copy around the window. Now, as I've done that, you'll notice that I've missed part of the window. So what I can do is I can actually click this option up here to add to the selection. And now we have a better selection, but it's a little bit too wide at the bottom. So I can now subtract from it as well. And now we have a cleaner selection. Now that I've got my selection, what I can do is actually duplicate it. And there we have the new window. And that's something that you can do with the patch tool very easily. It makes it easy to actually duplicate parts of an image and copy them over. And you could carry on duplicating them as many times as you need to. And of course, when you've done, you could actually remove the window as well, and that way you would have moved it into a new position. Now, if you want to have a go at this image, you'll actually find it on my website to download. It's actually part of the book downloads, but you don't need the book. You can just go and download the image. I'll put the link to both the book and the image in the information for the video below. I hope you found this useful. I'm Robin Whalley. You've been watching Lenscraft. I'll see you soon for another video.